Welcome back to the Ghostski. I am Gray, and today we have more of what you need, which is our Carthaginian Rome 2 Total War campaign. And I don't know how to connect that to anything that we're about to do, but we're about to do it. If that makes any sense. Anyhow, alright, so. Last time we conquered Iole and Dimiti. Now, we're basically going to eat up some turns, let this region kind of stabilize a little bit, put a little bit of money into this stuff, and that's pretty much it. Basically, wait till we get about, you know, a little bit of a garrison at Iole, and then we will move west to take out the Getuli. And the reason why we're doing that is because we want to reestablish our foothold over here, over in the Iberian Peninsula. Like I said, we'll see how this goes, and then maybe we'll end up attacking Rome. I don't know. Maybe. Maybe we'll do that before they get any of their, you know, quote-unquote endgame units and shit like that, before they get really threatening and stuff. And before we, you know, kind of end up stretching ourselves a little thin. I don't like that. That makes me angry right there. That little army right there. But anyhow, alright. We do have an opportunity to go take Alalia here soon. But that, like I said, is going to be after, I think, we take out, continue our western exploits, I guess is the best way to describe what we're going to be doing here. So yeah, we're just going to kind of, end our turn. The reason why I was just kind of like waffling around and looking at shit there is because I kind of try to do that. When I load up a campaign, I kind of gotta like survey everything so that I remember what the fuck I was doing and where my resources are. Because I've done that before. I've created, you know, armies and shit and recruited a bunch of units and then just completely forgot I did that. And yeah. So, in order to, you know, kind of keep an eye on and remember everything that we're going and doing here on this campaign, especially when you're spread out like we are, kind of takes a little bit to, you know, remember where in the fuck we are and where in the fuck we're going with a lot of stuff. Should we trade with the Adatani?
Maybe. My people values.
Maybe. You are now. Cancel that, because we're dickheads. So we are assholes. I like how those guys are like kind of at a standoff there. There we go. You're gonna come back and attack us. Usually these are the battles that I skip over, but for the sake of doing them, I think I should do it. Because, yeah, I think I should. Really do think I should. So, plus we at least have some ranged units at our own disposal to help counter their horses specifically. I'm not so worried about their javelin men, because we can obviously run them down with our cavalry, so that's that. Wow. We have a garrison fleet, so like literally one boat has like four dudes on it. Like what the fuck, right? Anyhow. Hopefully they should be attacking us, so they should come at us and we don't have to chase them down. Should, hopefully. Hopefully that's the case. Makes this sort of shit a lot easier when they do shit like that, when they are desperate to take a settlement. You know, see, this is, once again, this is what I like. I like it when they attack us, when they come out after us, they try to take us out. I appreciate that. I'm okay with that. I want them to do that. God damn it. Because I want them to kind of I just like them being aggressive. I like them attacking us. I like them coming at us. Makes it a lot easier to take out them instead of playing this little fucking hide-and-go-seek game, which I hate. But anyhow, as soon as this loads up, which this game kind of does have long load times. It's weird. Like, it's weird. Like at first it will, but then later it, like, when you first start up the game, it will, but I guess as everything gets cached and all that good shit, it kind of, doesn't take quite as long, which is okay, I guess. But anyhow, once we get underway here, we will get started on moving west. Basically what we're gonna do is, I think we're only gonna need one army. Like I said, we may pull, was it the Sacred Companions or whatever that army is that's stationed at Dimity right now. We may move them in behind us just to put a garrison in, like Tingus or something, as we move on to Migdol or something or other. We're really going to wait till this unit gets fully healed and fully whatever you want to call it, up to speed and whatnot. And then we'll be on our way, I think, heading out west. So there's the game plan for the rest of this episode. Hopefully we can, it might take a while. Obviously things like this are going to slow us down a little bit. But hopefully we can kind of get going on that shit. Do I even really want to like do anything here? I don't wanna, let's just go. And just fucking do that, and I think that, oh, maybe we'll go double line with you, and we'll go double line with you, because I like double line. I just do. Alright, so go. Go. And we are going to speed this up, just for the sake of it being, you know, some really small units. We really don't have to worry too much. Oh boy, we're going a little too fast here. Go ahead and have them attack. Anyway, okay, the rest of you guys are just kind of standing there.
What are your orders?
You go after them. Because I don't really want to use those units that we have in reserve there. Alright, you guys have yet to I didn't want you throwing javelins at them. I want you to waste your javelins on these assholes over here. These assholes. No. You. I am having all sorts of fucking problems with that lately. Just units just going off and doing whatever the fuck they feel like doing. A lot in this. This campaign specifically. It's been really irritating.
Our general is under attack.
You guys are in melee. You actually are in melee combat with these fuckers. These are the only things that the Numidian cavalry are the only things that are irritating here. It's, let's go run those fuckers down. Why are you not throwing? Seriously, what the fuck? Seriously, what's the fucking deal here? Did we? Oh fuck, they're still in there. Continue attacking them. They're pretty much done. Yay, now we're actually throwing javelins at the right shit. Like, I don't know what the fucking deal is. I mean, I really don't know why I'm having so much trouble with that shit right now. Who are those? Really, Shiva? You gonna complain while I'm recording? Because you do that? Alright, we're done there. Wonderful. We have now... pretty much that should be, unless if you had another army somewhere, that should be the end of this faction. So there's that. Yeah, don't know what else we really need to talk about here. I'm trying to remember if there's anything. I'm trying to figure out really if there's anything I should be doing. I'm trying to fucking figure that out. I don't think there is. I don't think there's anything I'm missing right now. In terms of shit we need to fucking do. Like I said, really we just need to eat a bunch of turns, get some cash, upgrade some buildings, stabilize the region we're at, and then move on. That is one thing that this game does not... like, it's much more slower. To me, it feels much slower moving than the other games. The other ones you could kind of come in, blow up, stabilize real quick and then move on. This one seems to be a little slower. It just takes a little bit longer to kind of get all your ducks in a row, so to speak. Did you guys just lose Kartuma? You fucking assholes. How dare you? Yeah, we totally destroyed those assholes. Got rid of them. So one thing we are interested in maybe taking is this settlement. If we have a chance, we will, but that's going to be one of those things that's on the back burner for a while. So, there's that. I am kind of screwing us, considering I'm taking our one of our spies and moving them east. But I really, like I said, I just really want to scout Egypt real quick, just to see how things are over there, just to kind of give us an idea of what to look for or whatnot, or look out for, I guess. Because, you know, I'm kind of, like I said, I'm with us kind of focusing off to the west here, we're kind of leaving ourselves exposed leaving our eastern borders exposed to other factions, whoever that may happen to be. It is kind of weird, though. We're not at war with anyone over here. Everyone's pretty happy with us. It's really weird considering our cultural differences over there are pretty big, really. It's kind of weird that no one's like coming after us, but it is what it is, I suppose. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna change you into our fishing port, because I like fishes, they're delicious. And homestead, maybe? Gathering place? I don't know what I want to build. Let's build a gathering place, because you don't really need food right now. So we'll put that on the back burner and wait till a little bit later. And then we'll go ahead and jump on that. Because, you know, that's kind of what it is. We do need, if I remember right, yeah. You are that guy, okay. We do kind of need, I think we need to work on our faction a little bit. Our influence, just a little bit. Just a little bit. But, not too much of shit. We might be able to move here in a couple turns, so, that's good to look forward to. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this turn. We'll just turn it over and see what happens. We should be alright in terms of, shouldn't have anyone attacking us, shouldn't have any warfare to take care of here anytime soon. I don't like how Rome's moving around out there. That's kind of getting me, it's kind of worrying me a little bit. Once we do get, I think once we start moving west, we're going to start pumping more money into Carlos there. And upgrading some of the shit that's there so that we can have a better garrison, obviously, and the garrison can stand on its own, and we will begin putting troops into that military that's right up there, army that we have right up there that's gonna take Alalia for us here shortly. But that's also, I don't know, I'm kind of on the fence about that idea right now, just because I'm not quite sure how much money we're gonna have. Money coming in isn't too terrible right now, but obviously as we move west even more, which by the way, I did see an army moving this way. We need to go, do have a scout heading that way. We're gonna go take a, there, neither of them are there. So you are coming this way, okay. What have you got for me? Wow. Not good spearmen. A lot of ranged. Not very good spearmen. Okay. Alright, that's okay. We're okay with that. I kinda wish. Maybe we can get luck. Ooh, yeah. That might be something that'll be fun. Can we? Ooh, yes. Let's just slow patrol and see if we get lucky and slow their movement down. Because then if we can do that. Yeah. You get fucked up, son. You get fucked up. Alright, so now what we're going to do is we're going to do this. We're going to start moving him this way. Because we're still in our region, until we cross this line right here, we can still regen our troops. So obviously that's going to be something that will happen next, and we may be pretty much close to full strength going. Ooh, and hey, look at that. and we can still maintain control of all this shit. So that's good. That is very good. And we will wait till next turn to see if we need to move him, move the Sacred Company up to Iol, because we'll see what they do. If they, he can't move at all. Oh, fucking yeah, that's what I'm talking about. He can't move at all next turn. Shit. Because what I want to do is I want to attack these guys out in the open. Reason being is because I want to get at those ranged units. I don't want to go to Tingis and have to take care of them and get hammered by all their slingers and shit the whole damn time we're attacking the settlement. So, that's the idea. I wanted to go out and I bought some... Is there anything we need to dump some money into? Like I said, we'll think about... I may just wait. Maybe. Maybe. Well, we'll build that. We'll work on the garrison at least. We'll at least do that, because we really want that as a big, big stronghold out there, and give us some more. Give us some more to defend that fucker with. So, all right. So yeah, we'll just end the turn right here, and then we'll continue moving west. Because like I said, we're at a pretty good pace right now, I think. I think, anyway. Shit, I did not move. Damn it, I should have done that. Should have moved that diplomat for the west. That's really what I should have done. Forgot to do that. I got a little excited and shit. But anyhow, it is what it is. I really want to take the fight to Rome here soon. I really do. I really want to take Lilibium and take that island. I really do. I want to take that shit and get those boats, like, off of our territories. Or, not off of our territories, but farther from our islands, I guess. So, not really our islands, I guess I should say. Farther from our heartland, you know, which is this area right here. This is, you know, this area makes a ton of money. This right here makes a ton of money for us. Africa is going to make a ton of money. A ton of cash. It's going to be the financial center of our empire, and we really want that to be what it is. So we're gonna subvert you again, because I'm awesome. And we're gonna need to do that a couple more turns, I think. And you still can move pretty far, but you can't attack in that stance. So we're gonna move you. Yeah, you're pretty much good to go. So we're gonna move you this way. And hopefully, fuck, we may not be able to.
My lord.
Ah, shit. Ooh, can I actually get to you?
Undermining
nope.
Authority.
Damn, I didn't think so. I was hoping, because like I said, I really want to take these guys on out in the middle. Out in the field, as opposed to behind the walls here, because, like I said, just taking all that ranged is really going to wear us down a lot. Especially as, like, the javelin men, they tend to do pretty decent damage, albeit they don't have, you know, much for ammunition, but they usually can put quite a hurting on you. But anyhow, alright, so we'll end that turn there, because that's pretty much all we really wanted to do. And then we'll, yeah, fuck you. Oh, you're moving around and you make me nervous. Fucking Rome. Fucking fuckers. One thing that I wish you could do in this game, I wish you could buy and trade settlements. You used to be able to do that, like, take control of settlements and shit. Ooh, they're sending more. Oh. You guys are making shit interesting now. Very interesting. Very, very interesting indeed. That's not what I expected them to do. I thought they'd just retreat right back to Tingis and... Oh. You are just sitting around out here, aren't you? I did not make you go any farther, did I?
How can I serve?
Alright. Um. You know what I am going to do? I am going to recall you and bring you back. I want to bring you back towards Skydalgus. We'll do that. Is there anything I need to build over here? Well, fuck, yeah, there's a ton of shit I need to build. Damn. I really should do that, actually. I should just keep building the buildings for now.
My lord.
And not worry about the monies. Okay, the Sacred Company's in a decent spot. I think they can handle themselves for the most part. However, where do we want you? Okay, so you're not that far, are you? No. What we're gonna do with you is go this way.
I cannot pass, my lord.
I really shouldn't, because I want to save, should save the cash and not do that. But I am going to go after you and just keep going west, because I kind of do want them to try and ambush me out here. This is where I want to take them. I don't want to take them behind the walls. I keep saying that, and I fucking mean it. So hopefully I can kind of draw them into a confrontation. I doubt it, because they're pretty wise to that sort of shit usually.
We fight for you, my lord.
So, yeah. Okay. Good thing is, these Numidian spearmen are not very good. In comparison to our spear units, I mean, they're going to get pretty hammered by us in melee combat, so I'm not too worried about them. If they do attack us, we'll have to be smart and use our javelin men to counter their skirmish cavalry. Their javelin men cavalry things. We'll have to be smart and that's what I wanted. That is exactly what I wanted. So, all right. As I was saying, it's going to be pretty simple. We're just going to match up strength for strength, I think, with our spear unit and theirs. We'll win that easily. And then we'll just run around and rout their ranged with our cavalry. And hopefully, this is going to take some micromanagement. Hopefully, we'll be able to use our javelin men to counter their skirmish cavalry, because that's the one thing that they have that will be a pain in the ass. And like I said, javelins tend to do a pretty decent amount of damage. So we're going to want to take those fuckers out, because those are really the only thing that's threatening to us. Like I said, the slingers, not really that worried about their slingers. Because like I said, those will be able to rout and run over with our cavalry pretty easily. It's just the skirmish cavalry. In other words, this army that we have built right now is pretty well built to take care of everything that they've got. So they're attacking us, is that correct? Of course, you know, they have no idea where we're at, and we have no idea where they're at. So what I think I'm gonna do...
Enemy reinforcements approaching.
Well, they're not coming from behind us, so I'm not that worried about it. So I think we'll just kind of stay in a defensive position, I guess. I don't know. Don't know where they're at, and I really don't want to get strung out looking for them. Or, you know, getting surrounded and screwed. So we'll just let them march towards us if they plan on doing that, which... I'm just going to wait for a little bit and see if anything happens. This is going to be some bullshit if I have to go out and fucking find them. I mean, they're the fuckers who attacked me, right? I mean, come on now. And I typically do get very, 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 very impatient when it comes to shit like this. Just because it's like, come on now. I mean, I just want to get this shit over with. Let's fight. Damn it. Let's fucking fight. I do kind of like our position, though. I do like this. I mean, we're not quite on top of the hill as I would like to be. But hey, look at that. Let's slow it down now. Alright, so now we at least know sort of what direction that they're coming from. So we're gonna move up here.
The gods are with us.
Keep our cavalry back kind of behind the hill. I kind of want them to stay there. I want to fight on the hill so that they're not coming down the hill at us. I kind of don't like that idea. It's a pretty fucking steep hill, isn't it? Jesus, it just drops right the fuck off there. So that's the idea. Now, of course, they are, you know, now just completely, oh, there we are. Oh, there you are. Let's have you. Oof, this is perfect. This is nice. This is actually gonna work out real well. I think. I hope. Alright, so we got you guys. You guys collapse that way. You guys collapse in on that. And they're gonna get strung out, chasing us with their spear units. As we hit them from behind, and I'll just attack them real quick. I want you to be a little closer to support them. Oh my god, did they really stop and fight us over here? Holy shit. Now this could get pretty ugly if we don't route these guys fast enough and these spear units get up to us. Because I'm not interested in fighting these spear units, obviously. We also have a huge bonus against large, which we're going to kind of classify as large, but I think we do anyway. Really don't want those guys. Where in the fuck are you going? Seriously. Go that way, damn it. Alright, at least you guys are on the move, attacking them. Let's go this way. And take out their ranged, because now that's what I'm interested in. They're enraged, aren't they? Enraged? In range. In range. Let's see. You guys are not attacking anything. Go that way. Why? Just throw your fucking thingies at him. You guys are gonna fuck them up, I think. So now you got them chasing us, but they may be running out of ammo before too long. And yeah, we got all these guys on the run, so yeah, see, that's what I thought. Get those fuckers on the run here. Oh boy, I hate when I fucking do that. Hate that it centers on units like that. Yeah, there you go, you guys got that. Their cavalry is pretty much on the run here. You should be able to handle that, right? Our cavalry is going to take a bit of a fucking hit here. Alright, now I want you guys, these guys, to come back this way. Or... yeah, let's have them just hurry back.
The battle is turning in our favor.
Yeah, it should be turning in our favor, you fucker. Shit. Seriously, you guys getting attacked by like three cavalry? Like three dudes on horses? Having trouble handling that? You guys, fuck it, you guys handle that. Aww. Alright, so that's that. We're not gonna chase them down, although we should, honestly, chase them down, but I mean, they're not gonna have all that much left. Just a few ranged units, I think. Not quite sure about the other army, obviously, but damn, look at that. 719 kills to 84. Yeah, we had the better units. Like I said, we were very well equipped to take out their army with the amount of cavalry that we have. I mean, it's the best way and almost the only way to deal with ranged units, especially like large amounts of them. I mean, and things like slingers. I mean, those are almost never armored at all, so you can just run through them and stuff and all that good shit. Some, I don't know. And you go running that way, and you go What the fuck? There's a boat over there with dudes? Holy shit. Didn't notice that. You can probably hear the fireworks that are going off in the background as it is, you know, nearing the 4th of July. And that apparently is a holiday, you know, that people give a shit about. Oh boy. I guess we'll go ahead and finish off this arm because we can't get past him unless we do. So, we'll go ahead and do that now. And then... I'm not sure if they'll give us, if we'll still have the movement points after this to go ahead and assault Tingus. That'd be nice if we did, because then we can just wrap that shit up, and then we might even be able to then take Migdal too. Maybe. That may be something we wait till next time, just because of how long and how far we had to travel. Then we'll just go and take that next time. So, all right. So, this is gonna be pretty simple. Since they don't have very many units at all, it's not gonna need any elaborate game planning to take these fuckers out. It's gonna be real simple. We don't have any trees or anything. All right, I was gonna say hide our cavalry off in some trees. Oh, we do have some over there, but. Yeah, it's not really going to be all that effective and worthwhile, so we'll just start. And I kind of want to be up here. Let's go this way. And have our cavalry go right up there. If they are up here on the left, which they might end up being, then we'll be able to at least kind of hide the cavalry around here and... Surprise, man. No, they're over here. What in the fuck are you doing all the way over here? Shit. Now, why can't I? There we go. Alright. So I guess we will go over here. And, shit, should have hit my cavalry over there. Goddamn. Would have been pretty smart. I believe that's all they got, right? I mean, are they stashing units away somewhere or something? I hope not. Okay, now we're seeing more of their units. Not much of them, but they're still there. It'd be great if they just, you know, let us just encircle them. Why are you not running? I wanted you to run. Did I not tell you to run? Fuckers. Alright, now you guys can start hauling ass. Since these guys are, and we'll slow it down here now that we're there. The horses are hidden. So we're gonna move them out that way. And apparently just do this with one unit of fucking spear, or one cluster of spearmen unit. I call them units, you know, each one of these individuals are units. I don't know, that's just me being me, I guess. No, we don't want you to go out there and attack them. Are you actually going to go after what I want you to go after there, horses? Alright, yeah, I guess that works. That's what we want. Should we throw spears at the Numidian spearmen? Yeah, fuck it, let's do it. Let's throw spears at these guys. Maybe, yeah, rout some of these fuckers. We are at your command. This'll go quick, I mean, this'll be pretty short once we get there. That's one thing that's kind of irritating, like, a lot of these smaller battles, this is why I usually just, I guess, simulate past them, is because half the fight is just moving people, and the other half of it is all of, like, you know, 2 minutes of fighting, and that's it. It's not even, like, any real strategic taxing battle or whatever. Like I said, it's usually just show up, kick their asses, and, you know, take 10 minutes getting there doing so. But, like I said, I'll do them, keep saying this, I'll do them for this LP, just to just to do them, just so that you don't miss out on anything. Just, I don't know, it feels kind of cheap when I do it, though, quite honestly, when I sim through these, you know. Like I said, if I'm gonna record this shit, why not? It's more fun to do these little easy battles anyway. Then, you know, at least you do get to see, like, some of the really cool shit, like taking cities and whatnot. Like I said, I wish I would have chosen, like, a barbarian faction, because I think their cities and their city layouts and stuff are really cool. I like the way they have the walls set up, as opposed to some of these, I guess, classical factions. This is what you'd call some of this, like, the classical architecture with the walls and how you have to go up on them and then get off of them and stuff like that. I don't like them as much as the other territories. And quite honestly, like, when you defend the barbarian cities and stuff like that, they're just, and Celtic, I guess, those would kind of, like, group both of those together. They are separate cultures, I guess, in this game. The Celtic and the barbarian cultures, I guess. Or just, like I said, just a lot of fun to defend settlements with, just because they're, like, their city layouts and shit are really, really interesting. A lot different than I've ever seen in any other game. Aha, fuck you. Alright, now that we're done there, can we make it? Oh my god, we're gonna make it. Three in a row. Alright, all we have to deal with is the garrison army. Once again, this is going to be a lot of walking around and climbing the damn walls, more so than it will be fighting on the walls. But we're going to do it anyway and take Tingis. Because we need to. We have to. It's what we are meant to do. I may at some point, maybe when we're done with this one, do another, play this game again. I don't know. Like I said, there's a few factions out there that I want to play as and stuff, so. And quite honestly, I've never beaten this game. I've come very, very close. The first time I played it when it first came out, I got very close to beating it and just kind of lost interest. I mean, it was, god, like 8/10 of the way through the game. I just kind of quit and then never picked it up again. And then when I uninstalled and reinstalled and wiped my computer on stuff, I lost that save file, obviously. So I don't know if there's any factions that actually unlock when you beat it. I would assume that there are, because that's kind of the way they do things usually in this game, so. Ooh, yes, we like rain. We like rain. Oh, fuck. What's with all this shit? This is it right here. Oh, fuck you. Fuck you. Where are we going to take the least amount of... Yeah, it might be over... It might be this one right here. Fuck it. That's where we will go. Alright, you four fuckers. Get over here. The rest of you guys, I'm gonna make you unit one, you unit two, and I don't give a shit about cavalry in this fight, so that's that. You go there, you go there, you go there. Fuck it, I guess you go there. I don't know. Go get shot at by arrows, and I want the rest of you fuckers over here. And you fuckers over here. And that's your, whatever you want to call it, your boats. Fuck you, getting in the way and your shitty pathing errors. I think I got two of them going to the same spot. Can I make you go out a little bit farther? There we go. Of course, you're all going to get stuck getting around this fucking corner. Which I wish they would kind of... I don't know. I don't mind them taking the shortest route possible, but yeah, they just kind of get stacked on each other like this sometimes. It's kind of irritating. Just a little bit. I think what we are going to do is we're going to come over. Why don't you guys move into that spot? I want to double line you too, to make you a little more compact. And get in there, and you guys get in there, and oh shit, these guys aren't going to make it. fuck. See, that's why. That's why. Oh, shit. That's why we don't like... That's why we don't like having all of this ranged. That's why we didn't want that army in here at Tingis when we assaulted it, because we would be getting all sorts of fucked up. And we did lose that one unit, by the way. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna have to go. It's really hoping to assault it right here too. I don't even know why I'm fucking throwing shit at these guys. Probably should pull them back, and I am gonna do that. I don't want them to get fucking shot at the whole goddamn time and lose all these guys. These guys are pretty good for Peltasts. I mean, not a big fan of those. Not a big fan of Javelin Men, but they've worked out pretty well for us. We are gonna get these fuckers. Jesus, we're gonna lose another one. Good god. Just get up on the walls and kill these fucking dickheads.
An entire unit has perished.
These are pretty good units, too. We lost a couple decent units of Carthaginians here. Carthaginians? They're all Carthaginian. Carthaginian Alphatase, and we'll probably lose another one or two, in all honesty. Jesus, how are you getting fucking shot at way back here? Goddamn. That's uncalled for. Shit. Now I'm pissed off. Mm-hmm. It's like fucking Football Manager all over again. Goddamn. What the hell is this shit? And these are just fucking straight up archers too. Archers are good in this game. I enjoy the archers quite a bit. Quite a bit indeed. But at least we should theoretically have no problem taking these fuckers out. Should. Tribesmen, are these good, or are they just fucking militia fuckers? Shit. Alright, we took them out. Let's go this way and fucking kick their asses. These dickhead Numidian spearmen. Hopefully this doesn't take too long. We get shot by all these goddamn arrows forever, which is what it looks like is happening. So, not a good day. Not a good day. Goddamn, are you serious? Fuck. Picked the wrong spot to fucking do this. Jesus. Fucking hell. Get out of there. It doesn't fucking matter. You guys are gonna get fucking shot and killed before you fucking get over there. Sweet fucking Christ. Yeah, a bit much, you think? Jesus. Yeah. This is why, as you can see, that is why we really wanted to take them. Oh, Christ. Attack these guys. What are you guys doing down there? What in the fuck? What in the fuck is going through your tiny little heads? It says, hey, we should totally fucking be down here doing stuff. Like, legit, seriously. Just kill these stupid fucking archers. Fuck you. Come on. They're just archers. Please. Kill them before we lose too many. This is just the garrison army. Remember that. Remember that shit. This is just the garrison. This is just the shitty fucking six units that are here. So it's all the goddamn archers they got. Shit. Usually they have like two units of archers and, you know, like a couple of mobs or something like that. But this faction apparently just has a hard-on for archers and everything they have is fucking ranged. Which makes this sort of shit difficult. I wanna get you, I wanna get you guys up here. Go. Just go. Make it quick. I ain't got all day. Stupid fucking archers. Shit. Fucking shits. Yeah, I don't know what these guys are doing over here. Quite honestly, I don't know what they're planning on doing. I don't know what their game plan is. I'm kind of unsure. So that's neat though, the way it kind of, that's one thing that is really cool about this game. They did a really good job of like making the architecture really cool, really unique. And this is like really just like just the architecture is just super cool in this game. Like I said, they did a great job with it. Makes this game like makes besieging settlements and stuff like this really fun. Not to say that it like the architecture has ever been shitty in these games, but it just really like they really went above and beyond in this game, I think. And just like that's my favorite part of it. Like I said, this like it makes you want to play as every culture. Just to see their different architecture and shit like that. Like I said, I mean, I didn't expect when I picked the Suebi campaign, and when I started playing that, I didn't expect that to be, you know, not necessarily all that fun. I just didn't expect it to be. Oh fucking hell! What is the goddamn issue here? Sweet Christ! Just attack these fuckers. Goddamn. Fuck. Yeah, seriously, we're shooting these fuckers while they're down there. Nice. Jesus, that's why. It shoots fucking four arrows now. Jesus. There we go. Jesus, that was costly. Fuck. 29 kills? They only had 29 kills? You sure about that? I mean, really? That means all the kills came from their fucking towers, I think. That's my understanding of that. But yeah, we lost fucking 3 units of Carthaginian Omnites, and that's not good. That's not good at all. That kind of puts a bit of a damper on our campaign towards Migdal there and finishing up this close victory. Yeah, what the fuck, right? I mean, that, like I said, that just took way too much out of us. Way too much. Syracusan General Hermocrates. Interesting. But anyhow, yeah, look at that. Like, that's all they fucking had. It's not great. Hell, we didn't even fight this unit. We didn't even get to that fucker. That unit got obliterated by the two towers that we caught. I should say the gate. We really shouldn't have attacked there. We should have attacked somewhere else. That's my fault. Really shouldn't have done that. Really should not have. That really fucking sucks. Really irritates me. Stupid fucking archers and shit. Goddamn shit. How many swear words can I use? What's this thing gonna load up? Like, seriously. Right, come on now. You're done. There we go. Oh, looks like they stab him in the nuts when they do that, doesn't it? It's like, aha, got you. Alright, we're gonna occupy this shit. The walls of Bursa. Alright, so. No, we lost only 2. Right? Is that right? I don't know. Point is, holy mother of God, we've got to convert everything. Oh shit, they're ahead of us too. They are ahead of us. And whatever you want to call it. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about. Yeah, that's right. You know it. Alright, so I think what we're going to do is we're going to do shipwright, maybe. I'll do a harbor. Just because we can. Yeah, fuck. They're really ahead of us here. Alright, we'll put in the muster field we're okay with. We'll tear that fucker down. Alright, so we will have a ton of shit to build next turn. And we do have some shit to build now. Or some of the shit to start working on. Yeah, I think we should do advanced construction techniques. Technicus. We did do weapon proficiency, tactical flexibility. We are going to want to do these here soon because we need to be up to speed with Rome and shit. When we take them on. That will be interesting indeed. Yeah, we'll go with formidable fighters. Because I like some of that shit. I'm going to. Tough ass, whatever you want to call it, army. There we go. Those are the words I'm looking for. All right, anyhow, so we have now conquered Tingis. Now, oh, fuck, McDowell's not that far away. Not that far away at all. So we are going to, and these guys will likely come and, no, they'll probably run away. Or they'll try and backdoor us at Iol, which is very, very possible. Which I think will probably be what happens. I'll call and you get over here and do your thing. And you, I want you to stay there for now. Barakas. And look over all that shit. So yeah, there's a small garrison there, but at least there we don't have to fight over walls and shit. Oh my god. Did you see our finances almost doubled when we took Tingis? That was a big, important place to take. Very, very, very big and important. A lot of money there. A lot of money. And I like money, 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 money. That's a good chunk of income, too, quite honestly. Per turn, you know, this stage of the game, $3,000. It's not bad. And that's pretty good. It really is. I mean, gives you a good chance to really put some money into your culture and build a lot of shit. A lot of shit. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to build some shit. I think we'll... I'm not going to say take some time off. But I think we're going to kind of...
Take this subsidy.
Nah, because we're dickheads. No. We want your territories. We don't want to be at peace with your ass. We want your shit. We want your shit. I desire your shit. And then... trade agreement dissolved. Oh, they get their ass kicked. Oh, they must have. Who's tearing shit up over here? Oh, the Lusitani. Oh, yeah. These guys are going to be, I think, our, Oh, wow, the Gallic Confederation. Jesus. We're not going to have a fun time with either of these. I think these are two really enterprising factions within the game. Every time I've played, they've done pretty well for themselves and really amassed quite a bit of wealth and shit, so... like I said, they are likely to be our main competitors on the continent, so we'll have to deal with that shit. However, in the meantime, we have Tingis, and we need to get that up and running, and we have a ton of money. Holy shit. Do we have some cash? We have a lot of cash. Let's see. What are the other two shrines that we already have? Because I like to vary them up. Just for shits and giggles. I have a shrine of Tynet. I have built something else down here, didn't I? I should just click on this because I can still see it from here. A start. I have the Baal Hamon. Over here, right? Oh, what in the hell? I did not want to click on that. But we do want to do this. Click on you, and yeah, Baal Hamon. All right, and you are Tanit, I believe, up here again. Yeah, all right, so we don't want any more of those, but what we do want is something else. We have a start, Eshman. Not really a big slave culture, Melkart. Yeah, let's do this one. That one sounds good. That one sounds good for this region. We're going to have a lot of industrial shit over here, so that will hopefully kind of complement some of that stuff. Which we can also do this. Bloop. Money, money, money. Anyhow, alright, so what should we build here? Hamnasia. Kapaloi. We want more money. We want to kind of encourage a bit more of our whatever you want to call it. Encourage a bit more economy here within our regions, because now we can kind of focus on that some of that war shit that we were focusing on earlier. So yeah, we got a ton of shit building. Eventually we're gonna start focusing. We're gonna focus. I'm going to focus here on Kart Hadasht here soon. However, like I said, depending on how the climate is over there, we are going to wait one more turn And depending on how, like I said, how everything goes over there with Lusitani and the Gallic Confederation, if they get aggressive towards us, then obviously we're going to have to work on that and kick some ass and take some names and then kind of put our war with Rome kind of on hold. And that's one thing that kind of sucks about this campaign is we are really, it'll be tough because we are at war with two pretty large factions on each side of our territory. And that's something that it's very good to just focus on one side.
I speak with
I don't want you to be a client state. Good idea, but no.
An unwise, even foolish choice.
Usually I would say, but yes, be my client state, but no.
I beg consider the glory lost forever if your troops
stand. Yes, we'll join war against Syracuse. I don't know why you want us to, but whatever. Considering nothing's really going on over there, but anyhow, what we are going to do is I think we'll have, I don't know, I'll think about it. I have an idea. I think what I want to do is I want to have like one army, maybe two armies over here, just to keep a hold on what we have, you know, blockade shit. Obviously, Tingis and something like Karthadasht would be good places to kind of hole up in, and then just maintain. We do have a ton of stuff over here that needs to be built. Really a ton of shit that needs to be built over here. Like I said, we need to start getting all of these up and running, really increase our money coming in, increase our income. That will obviously come with this shit as soon as some of this stuff gets finished. And of course,
how can I
wow. We're not doing too bad here. Repopping our troops. And what's the... Oh, wow. Wow. We already have a... the garrison's already full there, so... Fuck. Well, it is mostly Punic anyway, so I guess we don't really have to do any cultural conversion to get that shit happening. But anyhow, like I said, I think we'll do that, and then we'll, focus the rest of our armies. We'll put two of them, like one in Tingis and one in Karthadasht, probably, and then kind of this is not what I wanted to look at. This is what I wanted to look at. All right, and then we'll kind of, I think, focus everyone else on the eastern side of shit. And we are almost done with this. Chapter. So that'll be nice. Mauritania. We almost have Mauritania. Be at war with falling faction Rome. Training port. Traders. Blah 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 blah. Extra crap to do. Our ultimate objectives. That's where we're at. That's military victory though, right? Yeah, military victory. All right. I think we'll probably go towards cultural victory, but we'll see how that goes. We got a lot of shit to do, quite honestly. But anyhow, all right, so that's been a long-ass episode. We got a lot done, though, a lot of fighting out of the way. So anyhow, all right, so if you made it this far on YouTube, you know what to do. Thanks a lot for watching, and bye now.